news you can use. This is Sis Karen. Hadn't been on here a while, but today we're going to talk about scams. Though you're on the phone, you would think the pandemic, it would slow down, but scammers, missing all of it, is on a rise. Now, dealing with personal service, no matter how you set your account up, there's always someone that has a trick to try to steal your business identity. Unfortunately, we have people out here that do not do their fact finding, and they'll pay cash through Cash App and pay someone money, and they don't even know if the business exists. It does happen. So being a smart customer or business owner, only thing you can do is make sure that they get all the information that they can from all social media platforms or in person, however it may have occurred, the trail of curve, and report it to ic3.gov. It is a major thing that has been going on for decades, but what your customers can do, or for those that are not customers that think that they're customers that knocks on your door, say that, oh, I got an appointment. No, you don't have an appointment. You didn't book through our website. You didn't actually physically meet any tattoo artists. For those that are just so gullible and they rely on the social media or the internet to be the go-to of finding to get services they want provided, only thing you can do, refer them to IC3G, which is under the Federal Trade Commission, and let them report any information that they may have obtained. But most likely, the most person that does that, because they're so gullible, they don't even think. They just send their money through Cash App, foolishly. It is not one of the recommended business apps to use if they're in professional business. Everyone knows when you're using Cash App, it's not traceable. Yeah, they may think it ain't getting over, but wonder if your customer sent it to the wrong Cash App ID. They can't dispute it. So you may want to think about the people that you're doing business with and think about if they got your money safe, or the business ought to think, do they got their money safe? Cash App is the quickest, easy, inventive way, but it's not good for businesses, not professional business. So think twice, even if you're a business owner, or even if you are a gullible person that relies on social media or pictures that you're thinking that it's a true count. Well, I hate to say, I don't care what they say in their inbox or their messenger, and they're saying that, hey, they work for this company and they give you a physical address and a name. You need to do more due diligence. You need to check the website. You need to physically call the company. You need to go and meet before you send out your money to someone that you don't know in virtual world. Come on, people. Let's get a clue. Be safe. Stop being gullible. Just because you see a person make up a page and they say that they are a tattoo artist or a beautician or barber, doesn't make sense for you to send money to a total stranger. A fake account that don't have any way or means for you to communicate or get back to or meet up, and you send your money, think twice before you do things. Just because you see a social media platform that has a name, oh, they got all these pictures, 9 chances out of 10, they stole it from other artists that's on social media, or some type of tattoo or beauty shop or barbershop business or massage parlor. Come on, use Clue. That is not how business go. You cannot find a true artist on social media. Yes, it's an advertisement thing, and it's great for business, for advertising, for business. But the business is at risk. All business is at risk. When you find some scammers or someone's out there plotting against your artists and to take money out of a business plate, it's nothing that a business can do. We can't refund your money back because you didn't do your due diligence, customer. But we can't promise you your money back through the government, but you have to be able to get information, find out what social media platform is. Is it true email address? And usually they're fake. It's very rare cases that they're using the same information. But what you can do is stop giving them information.
One of the top platforms that does scams. First off, you see a name like Charles Crystal, and then they have a whack-ass email. That should be your clue. It doesn't have any ties to the business that they're seeing, they work for. That should be your number one clue. If they just leave a telephone number and don't have a physical address, don't have a name of a business, and they send you a message and give you the address for you to meet for appointment, and you didn't verify through Google Maps or anything to see if the business exists, that's shame on you. But you're going to have to be smart. Just because you see pictures on people profiles don't mean that's what they do. It's called fake business, fake news. It exists. And there are scammers out there to get people like you. They're just so gullible to believe in pictures. And remember, in the past, I've always talked about people that sit up there and Photoshop their pictures. That's why I say, steer away from Photoshop. People that modify their work to make it look like it's something that they're not. There's tattoo artists out there. There's beauticians out there. It's all kinds of people modify their pictures to make something that is not true. And so when you go give their money, you thinking you're going to get that same look. No, it falls on you. You got to be due diligence. You can't believe what the next person told you. And then you got to look at the person telling you and referring you. Is they work really up to quality work? Everything that you think ain't good, do your research. Go around, talk to shops, talk to different artists that reside in business. Talk to beauticians, talk to barbers. Stop cash apping. Fact find. Find out the laws and regulations in whatever state you're in. Because every state have a different law. True facts, Texas do not do tattooing in anyone's houses, garages, or anything. And you have to have a license. So someone telling you that they're artists and they have their own personal license, no. They have to be the boss. And the boss is responsible for any artist that's under them. And they put insurance on the artists that work there. So do your fact finding. Better Biz Bureau have some shops. You can always do fact finding through Yellow Pages, White Pages. You can always go through the city of your city, state, tax assessors. They have information on who do what in their city. The city has that information. The zoning has it. The city zoning, if you just really want to know. Fact find by going through the information telephone line to see if those are legit telephone numbers. Hey, you gotta try. But why go through all this when you can easily do Google search and look and see what are the reputable businesses and go visit yourself before you even give them your funds? You gotta think smart because you put yourself at risk. Because when you walk up to those businesses and thinking that you're going to get your money back, you're not, because you did not book with the people that you thought you did. It is your responsibility to communicate with the business owners of the business, because anyone can say that they work for anybody on social media. And those businesses are not responsible for getting your money back. Now, they do tell you to contact ic3.gov. The only thing you can do is get all the information from that person that you foolishly gave your money to. Unfortunately, it happens to some of us. But just be careful next time. Do not pull your cards out and send no money through no Zelle and Cash App if you have not verified that it is a reliable source. Stay safe.